10 o'clock, and on BBC One Now we join Huw Edwards for the latest BBC News.
The crisis deepens for Yasser Arafat after the latest bombing in Gaza. Three Americans were killed. Arafat is blamed for failing to crack down on terrorist groups. We'll be hearing from the US Secretary of State, Colin Powell, about the depth of America's anger with the Palestinian leadership. Also tonight, gun crime is still rising, but police say they're making good progress. Delayed flights could mean automatic compensation for passengers. And the Chinese become the latest members of the Space Club.
In BBC London News, like rats in a box, the physical toll on the capital's cattle truck commuters and bushwhacked. London's mayor says he, for one, won't be lining up to meet the US president.
Good evening. The Palestinian leadership is in deep trouble tonight after a bomb attack which killed three Americans in Gaza. Yasser Arafat said he utterly condemned the bombing, but the Americans say it's his fault for failing to crack down on terrorist groups. The attack happened mid-morning. Security experts say the bomb was placed on the roadside and detonated remotely. It exploded on the main north-south highway that runs through Gaza. The American vehicles had just crossed into the territory near the village of Beit Hanun when the bomb went off.
The message from Gaza is clear. If you're American, you're not welcome. US investigators were among the first on the scene of the massive blast which killed three of their countrymen. As the stones rained down, they were forced into an undignified exit. A dark day for American diplomacy in this volatile region. But it doesn't need experts to establish the basic facts here. A huge explosion ripped through the US diplomatic convoy just after it crossed from Israel into the Gaza Strip. The car which took the main blast was bulletproof, but there was no protection against this. What's happened here comes at a time when Palestinian resentment of America is reaching fever pitch. Many people here increasingly see the United States as unquestioning supporters of Israeli government. America, the enemy. Now that seething Palestinian anger has cost American casualties. Superpower diplomacy is surely the only way the peace process can be moved forward. The danger now is that Washington's role here is about to change radically.
We are shocked by this latest terrorist outrage. The United States government will investigate fully and work with the relevant authorities to bring to justice those responsible for this senseless and brutal attack.
Yasser Arafat is facing renewed, scathing criticism from President Bush. Tonight, in an exclusive BBC interview, the Palestinian leader said his national security team is investigating.
We send them, all of them, the majority of them concerning this point to carry on who are behind it and who are working this dirty and shameful and very serious attack against our friends and against our colleagues, the Americans.
The fact is that Yasser Arafat's men did not prevent this bombing. The Americans continue to say that he is an obstacle to peace. This entire region is waiting to see what Washington does next. Jeremy Cook, BBC News, in the Gaza Strip.
Well, the American Secretary of State, Colin Powell, spoke tonight to our Washington correspondent, Matt Fry, and Matt joins us from the White House now.
Huw, of late, America has had quite a few bad days in the Middle East, and today was arguably one of the worst. So what did the country's most senior diplomat make of it all?
Enter Colin Powell, former general and now one of the most popular members of the Bush administration. It was a day that had started, like so many others, with some bad news from the Middle East.
For the first time ever today, American diplomats have been ambushed and killed in the Palestinian occupied territories. Does that mean that you're now drawn into that conflict?
No, I don't think it does. I just think it shows that there are terrorists, there are murderers in that part of the world that want to destroy the dreams of the Palestinian people for their own state. You know what our people were doing when they were murdered in this manner? a convoy of American diplomats was in the Gaza Strip to interview individuals who had expressed an interest in a Fulbright scholarship. We were going to bring them to the United States to study here as part of the Fulbright program. And that's the group that these people attacked and murdered three of their security people. We will not be deterred from trying to get Palestinians into our Fulbright program or pursuing the roadmap or trying to bring peace to the region. We will not be deterred.
And but where does this lead the roadmap for peace?
The roadmap is still there. It depends upon the Palestinian Authority coming together quickly, forming a government under, if it's going to be Mr. Abu Allah, forming that government quickly, giving that government political authority, and giving that government control of all the security forces in the Palestinian Authority so they can go after terrorists.
Then on to Iraq. In February this year, it was Colin Powell who went to the UN and made America's definitive case that Saddam Hussein posed an imminent threat.
8 months later, we still haven't found anything of substance. And now one of your former senior intelligence officials in your own department is claiming that you basically misled this nation and the world in that presentation.
That's nonsense. I don't think I used the word imminent in my presentation on the 5th of February. I presented on the 5th of February, not something I pulled out of the air. I presented the considered judgment of the intelligence community, the coordinated judgment of the intelligence community of the United States of America. And the information I presented, some of which has already been validated by David Kaye, and the investigation continues. We have found clear indications that Saddam Hussein maintained the infrastructure for chemicals and weapons of mass destruction. We found some evidence of them. We haven't found stockpiles yet. The work continues. The investigation continues. There is an individual, I guess, who is going on a television show to say, I misled the American people. I don't mislead the American people. I never would.
Colin Powell speaking to me there in the State Department, still robust and still vexed by questions about the causes of the war that simply won't go away, Hugh.
Matt, the White House, thank you very much. Gun crime in Britain is still getting worse, according to figures seen by the 10 o'clock news. Statistics published tomorrow will show the number of crimes involving firearms has risen again over the past year, but police are stressing that the growth in gun crime has been cut substantially. Margaret Gilmore has the story.
Police officers!
This is Operation Guinevere, a pre-dawn preemptive strike this morning against gun crime. 500 officers targeting those dealing in and using guns. This is how they tackle the problem in London, with overwhelming force against specific targets, rooting out the gangs and criminals driving Britain's gun culture.
There's going to be follow-up operations. The officers that have been doing this morning will be dedicated to firearms operations for the next 6 months or a year, however long it takes to convince people that gun crime is not acceptable.
Incidents involving guns have risen sharply across England and Wales, up 7% in 2001 and 35% last year. The BBC has learned latest figures published tomorrow will show another increase, but at just under 3% it's far smaller.
These figures appear to show they're beginning to get on top of the problem. In places like London, they've actually reduced gun crime, largely through specific targeting, as with today's operation. But in other cities where gun crime's still rising, there's a fear this may simply have displaced the problem.
Armed officers in Nottingham believe some of the gangs who've put guns on the streets here recently have come from other parts of the UK. They blame one specific thing for the rise in gun crime.
We've seen a significant increase in the amount of firearms incidents that the force had to deal with, and the majority of those through our intelligence are linked back to supply of Class A drugs.
Gun crime is a tiny fraction of all crime, yet it creates real fear. The figures, though, show where police heavily target the organised crime rings, they can have impact. Margaret Gilmore, BBC News, North London.
The Conservative Party official who raised concerns about the employment of Ian Duncan Smith's wife